A long, long time ago, in a galaxy very, very far away, Christmas morning was about to arrive for the little baby angry alien. Happy Christmas, baby alien! Like every Christmas day, Daddy and Baby Alien opened the Christmas presents together. But just after that, Daddy Alien disappeared because he had to go on a secret mission. Year after year, the little baby alien had to play with his presents all alone. Until one Christmas, while he was looking through his telescope at another planet, he saw a Christmas tree with loads of presents. Wait a second, angry alien. You aren't going to do something naughty, are you? On Christmas Day? Oh no! Now look here! You're not thinking of destroying all these presents, are you?
Here for you.
Pato says that this is the tie that he wanted for Christmas. Maybe the names on the presents just got mixed up. And so it was that Angry Alien was happy for the first time at Christmas. After all, the best thing isn't the present, but to have people to share them with. Merry Christmas, everyone!
Hello, everyone!
Hi!
What's going on?
Rocket!
Ah, you're making a rocket! Why? What's that, little alien? Oh, you're going back to your planet! Wonderful! Looks like they're ready for blast-off!
T-10.
Wow! This is exciting!
Professor Otto!
Welcome to another lesson with Professor Pato. Now, class, pay attention. Today we're going to talk about space. This is the sun. The sun. And this is the moon. The moon. Planets. These are planets and stars. Baby bird, can you tell us what that's called? Can you tell Baby Bird what those are?
Stars!
Those are stars!
It looks as if the angry alien has something he wants to say. Wonderful! Now we've all learned about space. Lesson approved by Professor Potter. You did it, Pocoyo! You flew into space!
Stop!
Planet?
What do you think? Is that a planet?
No! It is the sun!
You're right! That is the sun. You're going to drive, Pato? Oh, but... Whoa! Whoa! That's not a planet, Pato. Can you tell Pato what that is?
The moon!
It's the moon!
Yes, it's the moon. Look, little alien. Is that your planet? Yes, you've found it!
Houston, we have a problem.
Princess!
La 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 la!
Princess!
La 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 la!
Princess!
And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, run! That's it, run! Fred says, laugh! Come on, let's laugh! Fred says, dance! Let's dance! Fred says, that's all! Someone's knocking at the door. Oh, it's the little alien's parents. Oh, I see. It was just a game. But now it's time for the little alien to go home. Let's all say goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Looks like they're off on another mission.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
To the stars, searching for a planet, flying near the sun, flying near the moon. Rocket to the stars. Searching for a planet, flying near the sun, flying near the moon.
Bye. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
What have you got there?
Train.
Oh, splendid. Hello, Caterpillar. Hello, Pato. Hello, Ellie. Hello, baby bird. Hello, sleepy bird. Oh, what's this? It looks like a spaceship. And it's heading right for Pocoyo World. I do hope they're friendly. Well, at least they're polite. Oops! There's no reason to be scared, Pato. It's okay. Oh, dear. It seems quite taken with you, Ellie. Oh! Pocoyo, Ellie and Pato have something they want to tell you. They've just seen a spaceship. There it is. Just be... Oh, no, there. Pocoyo doesn't believe me. Will you tell Pocoyo where the spaceship is?
Behind you. In the back.
Yes, there it is. Look.
Pocoyo Brave.
Pato is also very brave. Oh, look! Why, it's a car. A teeny, tiny little car. They're aliens. Wahey! Acrobatic aliens. They're really, really friendly. Wow! Let's all clap for our new friends. What's this? Oh, I see. It's the Martian Brothers Circus.
Circus?
Yes. Don't you know what a circus is, Pocoyo? Yes? No.
Circus.
Incredible! It's a circus! Yes, Pato, it is rather small. The Space Zapper? Oh my! It's a full-size circus! Ha ha ha! Oh, it looks like Pato has found the space zapper. Oh dear, it seems if you push the wrong button, you could destroy the entire universe.
Circus.
Oh, I see. Our friend says they need to practice first, so we'll have to leave. What's that, Ellie? You want to stay and watch? Well, perhaps if we all ask nicely, they'll let us stay. Ready, everyone?
Please let us watch!
We want to.
Oh, goody! We can stay! Presenting the strongest alien in the galaxy! Ellie says your weights are very cute. They're so tiny. Oh, my! Bravo! Let's all applaud. And now, for our next act, the death-defying high dive! What's that, Pato? The high dive is too short. Apparently, that water is very cold. And now, the grand finale! That was terrific. Let's all applaud the Martian brothers. Oh, our friend here says it's time to put up some posters for the show. The Vamoosh! Pocoyo can take you in the Vamoosh. I wonder what Pato and Ellie are up to. Ah, hello, Ellie. Hello, Pato. Pato! Is that the zapper? But the Martian asked you not to play with it. He said bad things could happen. No, Pato, you mustn't. Go, dear. Ow! Oh, dear. Ellie, Pato, stop it, please! Oh, I wonder where Pocoyo is. Ah, all finished. Good job. Now we have to get back to the circus. Oh, it's an angry alien. I wonder what they're up to. What? It's the ultramagnetic 3000 magnet.
This doesn't look good at all.
It seems angry aliens like circuses too. Very good, Pocoyo. Now, there's plenty of time to get ready for the circus. Oh no! The angry aliens found the circus without you. Mr. Martian says someone has been playing with their things. They're all the wrong size. And someone has taken the zapper.
Ellie, Pato?
Ah, there they are. And they're making everything bigger. Oh, no! Ellie doesn't like people messing with her doll. Oh, this is getting out of hand. Somebody do something, please. Hello, Poco, you. Oh, thank goodness you're here.
Naughty, naughty.
Will you return the zapper? Thank you, Pocoyo. I don't know what would have happened if you hadn't arrived when you did. You're not thinking... Run, Pato! Faster!
Naughty, naughty!
Oh no! The circus aliens have been shrunk! And you've broken their zapper! And there's a tent full of angry aliens waiting for the show.
That's no problem.
What's that, Pocoyo? You have an idea?
Ta-da!
You say you'll do the circus? Right. Ladies and gentlemen, for our first act, we have... Fred, you're on.
It's the juggler.
Hit it, Fred! Good show! You're a hit! And now, in the center ring... Pato the Clown! Seems angry aliens don't like tap dancing.
Ellie.
Oh, yes, the mighty Ellie. Wonderful. Thank you, Ellie. For our grand finale, we have that avian of the air, Pato! Assisted by his somnambulant sidekick, Sleepy Bird! Joined by that magnificent millipede of the motorcycle, Caterpillar! Along with our winged projectile, Baby Bird! And Lula, the fierce lion! And Fred, not to forget, Fred! And on the high dive, Ellie! And blindfolded, we have Pocoyo! Oh, no! I can't look.
Hup, 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 hup.
drank all the water. The zapper is fixed. Bravo! Hooray for space circuses! Hooray for helping new friends! Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Lovely day, isn't it? Pocoyo, the little alien wants to take your picture. Beautiful flowers, Pato. I think your garden has some admirers. Very lifelike. How's ballet practice going, Ellie? Yes, it's very important to stretch. It seems you have some new fans. We've seen a lot of little aliens today, haven't we? Uh-oh. They want to take a selfie with your sandwich. Look out, Nina! It's time for the green aliens to go home to their own planet. He says thank you for everything. You say you all had a wonderful time? Well, that's great. Ellie says you are always welcome to visit again. But maybe not all at once next time.
Wait!
Oh, right! You want to give them a snack for the trip home. Very nice, Pocoyo. Bye-bye, everyone. Hi, Pato. You're looking sharp. Have you got a new job? Oh, I see. You've become an outer space postman. How exciting. And you've got an assistant. Who is this package for, Pato? Ah, to Green Alien. And it's a rush delivery? Well, you'd better get going. You wouldn't want your first package to be delivered late. Thank you. And we have liftoff! According to the address, Green Alien's house should be around here somewhere. Yep, here it is. Pato? I don't think that's him. Oh, I see. He says that Green Alien has moved and he doesn't live here anymore. But he would be happy to give you his new address. Well, according to this new address, Green Alien should be living right here. I'm afraid this is the wrong address. But no worries, the Torridoris know where he is. Looks like there's no one on this planet. I'm so sorry, Mr. Basketball. He says Green Alien's not here either, Pato, but that this is his new address. Green Alien! At last you found him! He's wondering what took you so long. The Vamoosh is out of fuel. The sun will take you back home. Welcome home. Good job. Quite right. Baby Bird deserves some credit too. Hooray for Baby Bird! Ah, winter. Pocoyo, Pato, and Ellie are enjoying sledding. Hi, guys.
Hi.
What fun. Oh, Christmas bells. I wonder where those are coming from. Over there? Very good, Pocoyo. You found the Christmas sound. Sleepy Bird's made her own Christmas tree. Well, it is Christmas time. Maybe you should get a tree of your own. What could he be looking for? What a mess! Well, he certainly seems determined to find it. Oh, I see. You'll cut down a tree for everyone. You've done it, Pato! You found the perfect Christmas tree! All set to cut? Oh dear. Seems he can't bear to harm such a perfect tree. But what to do now?
Aha!
Ah, it seems Pocoyo has an idea. So much old junk. It seems such a waste. Aha! Seeds! So that's what you were looking for. I see. You're going to use the seeds to grow a tree. Now we wait for it to grow. I'm afraid your tree may not sprout in time for Christmas. Wonderful! A new tree! This does seem magical. It seems that this tree is too small to even decorate. What's that, Ellie? You have a plan? Oh dear. You've all really created such a mess. Bravo! It looks like you have a Christmas tree after all. Now what? More mess? I see your plan now. Very clever indeed. This is quite the magical Christmas after all. A very Merry Christmas to everyone. Bye-bye now.
Well, hello, baby bird.
Oh, my! What was that?
I see. Can any of you tell Baby Bird who that was?
It's Pocoyo and Pato!
You're right! It's Pocoyo and Pato. And it looks like they're out for a ride in the Vamoosh. What fun! Oh, I think Baby Bird wants to tell you something, Pocoyo. Baby Bird wants you to teach him to drive the Vamoosh, Pocoyo. Maybe if we all say please. Ready? Now. Please, Pocoyo. Oh, please. Please let him. Please teach him.
Okay. After lunch.
Ah, Pocoyo will teach you to drive the Vamoosh after lunch, Baby Bird. I think Baby Bird is afraid you might forget, Pocoyo.
Promise.
I think Baby Bird is ready for you to teach him now, Pocoyo.
After play.
But you said after lunch, Pocoyo. Okay. Now, Pocoyo?
Later.
I know, Baby Bird. This really isn't fair. After all, Pocoyo promised. Now, Baby Bird, I don't think you should be messing about with the Vamoosh before Pocoyo has an opportunity to... Baby Bird! I can't look. No, I can't watch! Wake up, Ellie! Oh, dear. Oh, not again! However are you going to save Baby Bird? think Pato wants you to push that big button, baby bird. Ah, excellent. Good work, Pato. Now, everyone, I know you're upset with Baby Bird, but it's not entirely his fault. After all, Pocoyo, you made him a promise. Can any of you remind Pocoyo what he promised Baby Bird?
He promised to teach him to drive the vamoosh.
Yes, that's right. You did, Pocoyo, you know. You did. You promised.
Okay.
Ah, that's better. Hooray for Pocoyo and hooray for keeping promises. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Pocoyo and Ellie and Pato.
Hi.
What's that you're playing?
Marbles.
Let's see. You need to get your marble into that small hole right there in the middle, right? And how is everyone doing? What about you, Pocoyo? That's a special black super marble. Oh, I'm sorry, Pocoyo. You almost had it. Well, whose turn is it now? Wait! What's happening?
Yay!
Yes, Pocoyo, but how did your marble move all on its own? I think you've discovered a black hole. It'll suck up anything nearby. And you know what that means, don't you? Pocoyo, this is no time for dancing. Now come on, get away from that hole. Good idea, Pato. Grab that tree. Hold on, everyone. This is rather funny, isn't it? But I'm afraid we have to get Ellie out somehow. Can anyone switch on the light? Well, that's a relief. Everything seems to be fine, except for one minor detail. All the colors are reversed. Pato, you're not yellow anymore. Now you're purple. And Ellie, now you're green. You'd like everything to go back to normal, wouldn't you? Well, maybe there's a way. Are you thinking about how to get back to your world, Pocoyo? Well, you know, maybe your black super marble is the key. Maybe it can take you back home. Yes, Ellie, that's it. In this world, Pocoyo's black marble would be white. Now what? There you go, a white hole. Jump in, everyone. But Pato, don't you want to be yellow again? This certainly isn't your world. You're all made of paper. You'd better find that marble. Good job, Pato. Oh my. You're balloons now. Phew. You're back home, guys. You didn't leave anything behind, did you? That's a good question, Pato. What should you do with it?
Aha!
It looks like Pocoyo has an idea. A rocket? Oh, I see. Well, then I'd better start a countdown. Ready?
3, 2, 1, blast off!
Well, look at that. It's a magical nighttime. See you soon.
Pacto tras tan jedoma drogacja. Burdi, burdi, montan, desastro. Agri bel fino pro agri, tylko dropa nerek. Ja nie funkcjo pryskę nie bardzo. Pokro joda bies nie traga, da bezmiernie blodi.
Hello, Pocoyo. Hi, Nina.
Hi.
Having a picnic, I see. Mmm, and something smells good.
Mmm.
Oh, cupcakes, Ellie. I bet you worked hard on them. They look marvelous. Well done. Oh dear, Ellie. And you worked so hard. No cupcakes today. What a pity. A machine that can take you backwards in time? Oh, so you can go back to before the cupcakes were smashed. Brilliant! But how's it work? Incredible! We've gone back in time a whole minute. Guys, aren't you forgetting something important? No, Pocoyo, the banana peel. We can't let Ellie slip on it again. She's coming! Hurry! Tuck in. You ate them all. Oh, I see. You'll just go back in time again and have a second helping. But, oh dear, where are we? Yee-haw! We're in the Old West. But it looks like Miss Ellie isn't making cupcakes. Thank you. Well, I'd say that now we're in prehistoric times. Aha! The banana peel, of course. You're back in the present, and just in time for the cupcakes. Oh dear. Hard luck, guys. You're a bit late. No, wait! There's Ellie! And she made more cupcakes just for you. Bye-bye, everyone!
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
I see that you've got a brand new toy. What is it, Pocoyo? Do any of you know what Pocoyo's new toy is?
It's a plane.
It's an aeroplane.
Yes, that's right.
Plane.
Oh, Pocoyo loves his new toy plane. I wonder why he loves it so much. Oh, I think he's going to show us why. It looks like Ellie wants a turn flying the plane. Do you know how to make it fly, Ellie? That's right. You wind it up. But don't wind it up too much, Ellie.
Uh-oh. Then, no!
Look how high it's going. Oh, we've lost Pocoyo's plane. How can we find it if we can't even see it? Telescope! What a good idea, Pato! When you look through a telescope, you can see things that are far away. Quick, Pocoyo, look through the telescope! Well, it looks like the plane flew all the way up to outer space. How will we ever get up to outer space to get it back? Oh, of course, the Vamoosh!
some aliens. Don't be afraid.
Fun! But what about your toy plane, Pocoyo? Maybe the aliens know where it is.
Airplane!
I don't think you can reach it up there, Pocoyo. And nor can Ellie or Pato. Do you know anyone who could reach it, Pocoyo? I don't know. Maybe, or just maybe, someone very stretchy. Can any of you see someone who can stretch right up and help Pocoyo get his plane?
The alien!
Yay! Our new alien friend did it! Hooray! Oh, I think the aliens want to say something. Let's have a party.
Yay!
Terrific idea! By finding his plane, Pocoyo has found some new friends too. How splendid! Bye-bye. See you soon.
That looks like a lovely tea party you're having, Ellie. Who's your friend? Ah, Daisy. Very nice to meet you, Daisy. Well, hello, Angry Alien. Did you come to join Ellie and Daisy's tea party? Ellie's right, Pocoyo. Angry Alien has kidnapped Daisy. Oh dear, Pocoyo. You lost. Yes, this trophy is really nice, but don't forget your mission! will you ever get up to the other side? Pocoyo, look! A power-up! Well done! You beat the level! Look, Pocoyo! A key! Maybe if you lull Sleepy Bird to sleep... Pocoyo, that lullaby is terrible! Maybe you should get some help. Run! Now's your chance! Be careful! This level looks difficult. Remember, you still have one last power-up! Well done, guys! Angry Alien, the next time you want something, you just need to ask for it nicely.
Hello, Pocoyo!
Hi!
Oops, oh dear! Careful, that stuff's slippery, you know. Can you tell Pocoyo the name of that frozen slippery stuff?
It's ice!
Yes, it's ice. Pato is skating on the ice. Why not give it a try, Pocoyo? Beautiful! Hey, you're a natural. These two fine skaters displaying excellent form today. Really astonishing style. Here's a lift and... oh, tremendously tricky helicopter-like move from Pato, followed by a flawless landing. Both skaters demonstrating exceptional style and grace. Wow, perfect finish. We're really seeing two pros right at the top of their game. But we'll have to wait and see what the judges have to say. Baby Spider, give them a 10. And a 10 from Baby Bird. And Caterpillar, a 1. Oh, a 10. A perfect score for these two fine skaters. And here's someone we're all waiting to see. Ellie, surely one of the most graceful dancers. Athletic, ladylike, elephantine. Surely a winning combination. And here she goes. Lovely! A study in... Oh, dear! Ellie, are you all right? Ah, and here come Potter, Yo and Pato to help Ellie to her feet. Oh, hello, Fred.
Hi.
What's that? You're going to be dancing with a partner? Well, who is it? A saw? What can he be up to? It's Whale! You know, normally you don't see a whale taking part in skating competitions. This is really something. Fantastic height on this! And now for the catch. This is going to be spectacular. Well, let's see what the judges have to say. A 10 from Baby Spider. Baby Bird still hard at work. The pressure on these judges has to be extraordinary. What about you, Caterpillar? 10 from Caterpillar. So, it's all up to Baby Bird. Looks like he's decided he gives the performance a daisy wearing a hat and driving a car. Here's Ellie again. Looks like she could do with some encouragement to get her back on the ice. Can you help me to tell her to try again?
Try again!
You can do it!
Ah, here she goes. Very good. And... stunning! Oh, dear. Oh, Pato once again squashed entirely flat. But he's right back on his feet. That is one plucky duck. But it looks like Ellie doesn't want to play anymore. Perhaps she would do better if someone who's really good at skating helped her. Can you tell Pocoyo and Pato who could help Ellie?
Pocoyo and Pato!
Yes, that's a great idea. Help her! What's this? Ah, looks like Ellie has got a little help from her friends. Excellent. I do believe you're getting the hang of it, Ellie. Good for you. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for Pato! And Ellie, where did she go? Wow, just look at that! This is the kind of performance you see once in a lifetime. All she needed was a little help getting started. Stunning! A dazzling display from this pink pachyderm. But let's go to the judges. And it's... 3 tens! A perfect score! And 10s from the other competitors! Wow! Hooray for Ellie! Hooray for helping friends! Bye-bye! See you soon!